Hello, Bishop Wooden here, and let me tell you, I don't even know where to start. Maybe I ought to start by saying, hey, how you doing? Thank you for watching. Listen, this has been some week. The convocation that I've been talking about, the second annual convocation for North Carolina, third jurisdiction, is in session, and what a convocation this has been. It's the first time that yours truly has presided as jurisdictional interim, and since that time we've had a polling of the pastors and an announcement that yours truly, I received 100% of the votes, and the contact has been made to the presiding bishop, and the presiding bishop has accepted the polling from the brethren, so it looks like yours truly will be jurisdictional prelate for NC 3rd, and we will have the installation in the coming November meeting, and so that is something that is done, and I'm so humbled and so honored, and I'm grateful. I'm excited. I'm anxious. I'm filled with emotion, but I thank the Lord for what the Lord has allowed. First of all, God saved me and set me free and filled me with the Holy Ghost and blessed my life and called me into the ministry. And I never knew that any of these things could ever happen for me. And yet the Lord, for some reason, has chosen me to serve the church in this manner. And I will do my best to serve the church with distinction and honor, with the Lord's help and your prayers and you putting your shoulder to the plow. I think some good things can happen. Now, I've just come out of our day session today, and it's been amazing. I've heard from Dr. Eric Grail, Dr. Robert Foster, Superintendent Will Nichols and his wife Grace Nichols doing a presentation on marriage. Dr. Grail has been teaching on the Church of God in Christ. Dr. Foster, the importance of the local church, and my good friend, the Reverend Mark Creech, preaching on engaging the culture. I mean, we've had a full morning. Dr. Freeman has come up and talked about the Kojic Academy. Superintendent Herman Platt taught on protocol. Listen, where there's no order, there's chaos. And Pastor Willie Bamberg talking about our aim and how we've got to concentrate on the ministries of our church. Let me tell you, we've had a ball. Let me say this to you, and I'm going, but on last Wednesday night, I'll never forget the service as long as I live. My dad, Bishop Leroy Jackson Woolard, and it seemed like to me the majority of Greater North Carolina came to help us kick off this service. Bishop preached. They were so kind to us. My friends and colleagues from Greater North Carolina was here. My dad, Bishop Willard, was here. His wife, the supervisor of Greater North Carolina, the one and only Harrison Keys, they were here, and we had a ball, and it was such an awesome service. I'm just giving you a little recap and trying to tell you why, if I look like I'm tired, listen, I'm on cloud 100, not 9. We passed nine quite a few days ago. And on last night, the supervisor of NC 3rd, Mother Beverly Dejanet, oh my Lord, the Lord used that woman of God, and we were able to bring a smile to her face as we honored her on last evening. Well, this evening at 6:30, we're having a consecration service, an ordination service. I will be ordaining pastors as ministers are becoming elders in NC 3rd at 6:30 this evening, and on tonight, which is the official night, yours truly will be delivering the word of the Lord. Now, the theme that God gave me is that God said live, and I want you to come and hear what the Lord has given me on this subject. I'm asking all of the members of the upper room, all of my friends in the area, everybody who's watching this broadcast, to meet me tonight. Meet me tonight for the 7:30 service. If you'd like to come for the 6:30 ordination, please do. But for the 7:30 service, I want you to come. This is a historic meeting. It means so much to me. I have been moved. I have been blessed. And the Holy Spirit told me, the Spirit said, Patrick, he whispered in my ear, take it all in. And that is what I've been doing. I've been taking in the glory of the God of the Bible. And tonight, my friends, it won't be the same without your being here. So I want you to come. It's summertime. It's going to be a wonderful evening, a good evening to spend it with the saints. And come and help me preach my very first message as jurisdictional prelate of NC Third. The presiding bishop, Bishop Charles Edward Blake, has given me the nod. I will forever be thankful to Bishop Sedgwick Daniels for his leadership through this process. I will forever be thankful for Bishop Brandon Porter, a good friend who came and was with us on last evening, along with Bishop Sedgwick Daniels. I will be forever grateful to the pastor, Dr. Michael Anthony Stevens, who endorsed me and who was the progenitor, the man who led out in forming this great, great jurisdiction. Now, great things are going to happen here in NC Third. We're excited about it. We are going to lift up the God of the Bible. We are going to move the kingdom of God forward. We are going to be so aggressive in our attack against the kingdom of Satan that his gates won't prevail against our onslaught, our attack of him. We are going to move against the enemy, and you, my friends, must be a part of it. So I'll see you tonight, right here at the Upper Room Church of God in Christ. I'm preaching, and I want you to be here to get that God said live anointing. God said live, and I'm going to talk a little bit about what live means. It's beyond surviving and existing. God has more for us than that. God has big things in store, and you want to be a part of it. We'll see you tonight.